What's up, everybody? Corey here. Getting ready to start yet another decent sized carpet cleaning job here. This video is going to be more toward, I guess, if you're wanting to start a carpet cleaning business, you know, what would you need to start one? What would your investment be? What equipment should you buy? And try to cover some of the basics. If you're just finding this channel, if you're already on this channel, you've seen so much already, you know, you probably don't have that many questions, but let me try to, I guess, pretend like I'm talking to somebody that has never encountered this before and is wanting to start a carpet cleaning business and they know absolutely nothing. Generally, when you want to start a carpet cleaning business, the first thing you're going to think of is steam, because you think stainless steamer, you think, okay, well then I need to go with steam cleaning because that's the only way there is to do it, you know, which is logical thinking. You know, you think of carpet cleaning, you think of stainless steamer, steam cleaning, I should learn how to steam clean carpet. Then you start thinking about what kind of equipment should I buy. And then basically you fall into the hands of somebody that just does sales. So of course you should buy whatever in the hell they're selling. You know, that's what you're gonna get. I used to clean with steam, and I went out in 2001 when I began, and I think the van I bought was about $15,000. The steam unit I put in it was built by Hydromaster, so I bought a smaller unit. I think out the door, the investment for the machine and some of the basics of wand and everything that came with it, and all of the solution hose and vacuum hose, was right around 10 grand. And then when you start adding all of the other stuff to it, you'll spend about another 10 grand. And when you're done with that, you can charge exactly what everybody else is charging, and you get to compete with everybody that's been in business much longer than you and are better at marketing and getting clientele. And you've got to try to hurry up, and you've got to make that payment before they come and pick up the machine and the van and all of that. So keep that in the back of your mind, and I'm going to show you what I clean with and what I switched to after doing 6 years of steam. Let me turn the camera around and we will talk about it. All right, what this is a machine. I'm a Challenger OP dealer. I've been cleaning with one since 06. I've had this channel on YouTube since I think about 3.5 years now. And I started making videos with the machine. One I have out on the van that this one replaced. This is only about a month old. I made so many videos and had so much to say about Challenger that they made me a Challenger dealer now. So what this machine does, basically, is it orbits a towel through the fibers. It's called VLM, very low moisture cleaning. What it does is it orbits a towel through the fibers, and that's what removes the soil. Let me show you what that looks like. Now, it orbits the towel at ultrasonic speed. So you're getting a heck of a scrubbing, and at the same time it's scrubbing everything, it's transferring the soil from the carpet to the towel, and you change the towels out. So let's see here that should show you. And I can't just let it go. It oscillates violently. So let's see here. All right. So basically, the Velcro, it pulls the terry cloth towel on, and you change the towels out as they get dirty. So with this type of cleaning, what you do is you clean with a mild, neutral cleaning solution. What I've got in here, it's Orbit Natural and a shot of hydrogen peroxide. It's the peroxide I buy from Sally Beauty Supply. It's called Clear Volume 20, and that's 6% hydrogen peroxide. So you're cleaning with something that doesn't need to be rinsed from the carpet. It's not an actual soap. It doesn't leave any residue at all behind. So you're going to get to see me basically do all of this cleaning and be done with it and everything in basically just a couple steps. I've already vacuumed. That's the first step, and that should be your first step no matter what kind of cleaning you're doing. You're cleaning with steam, you vacuum first. Get all the particulate soil out. So then you spray the carpet, and you'll spray a smaller area because it dries quickly. So you'll spray like one room or possibly two, depending on how soiled it is and how long it's going to take you to get from one room to the other. Okay, and then you run the machine across it, and if it's not that soiled, you can move from room to room rather quickly. If it's extremely soiled with a bunch of different odds and ends in the carpet you have to get out, then you'll have to treat each of those individually, and it will slow you down. So I'm going to start in these two rooms here, and we're going to clean these, and I'll kind of work my way back out. And it's impossible for me to cover everything you're going to need to know. So if you subscribe to this channel, you will learn how to do this, because I do this every day and I put it up on this channel. Some videos are more inclusive than others with information, so it's something that you have to watch every day. So, I've been at this on YouTube for about 3 years now, and I was talking to a gentleman last night, which I thought was just absolutely, absolutely amazing. I mean, I've talked to a gentleman before. One gentleman I met, I think he's up in Utah, he had been in business 39 to 40 years. He started out, cleaning with a 175 machine, which is just a rotary machine, and then he went to steam, and now since he found the channel, he's actually back to VLM cleaning. I just ran into a gentleman yesterday. He started texting me a while back, but I started texting him more yesterday, and he's been in business 30 years, and since he found the channel, he's basically worked his way back to to VLM cleaning. He had four different units. He had four vans running. Three of them had a HydroMaster in it, and one of them was a Vortex. So if you know anything about steam at all, you don't get anything truly bigger than a Vortex. That's the biggest, most highest horsepower PTO driven machine that there is, And when you're cleaning with steam, you're injecting and extracting supposedly at the same time, but you have drying issues with steam and all kind of other little issues that you have with steam. So basically what this method does is, instead of continuing to add horsepower and PSI and CFM and vacuum to try to constantly get better by basically out horsepowering the next guy, you drop the horsepower thing completely altogether, and you approach it at a different, at a completely different mindset. So you're not rinsing in and then out of the carpet fiber. You're polishing the carpet fiber from where it attaches to the backing of the carpet to the top. You're cleaning that out, and you're not attempting to get the pad or the backing wet or any of that, because you're not going to clean that. Issues where there's pet odor and stuff, I take the pad out, I treat, and I'll clean the backside of the carpet. But you don't pour a bunch of stuff into the carpet and attempt to suck that all back out and get it all. I mean, if I were to, believe that that's the case, I would have stayed with what I had. I know basically that if you have a bunch of urine in the carpet and soaked into the pad, I could pull that piece of pad out, rinse it out, wring it out, rinse it out, wring it out three or four times and never get it all out of there. So the thought of you being able to pour something into the carpet and put something like a water call on it and suck all of that back out is just not logical. So, I know this because I've been in it about 20 years now, and I've come behind all the companies that have failed in doing that and just switched out the pad and did the backside of the carpet and fixed it that way. Some things you don't fix by cleaning or soaking the carpet in some chemical and trying to get around doing actual real carpet work. you have to know how to use a razor, and you know if you use an iron, you have to know how to use an iron and take apart and put carpet back together. A lot of the steam guys don't understand any of that. So, you know, not a real carpet man, maybe. All right. Now, I'm going to shut up for a minute and pre-spray two rooms, and then we will show some cleaning in those guys. All right, I'm going to try to stay in frame here. I can. Do now. I'm gonna go clean the next room and I'm going to groom both of these, and we'll come back and take a look, and I'll talk a little bit more about this. Alrighty, so like I said, two rooms. We'll take a look here. This is the first one that I cleaned. It's been cleaned and it's been groomed now. And generally, the environment is not really conducive for an hour dry time right now. They got all the windows and doors open. They're doing, I don't know what, they're doing painting and stuff, which is not conducive to paint drying either. But anyway, if you run the AC like you should, you can generally get 45 minutes to an hour dry time out of every room. So most of the time, almost all of the house will be dry by the time you leave, so it won't, you won't have trouble with it wicking back. So that's done, and this is done over here. We've got this area here, and then beyond that there is, I think, two more rooms over here. Let's take a look. I don't want to get anybody on camera that doesn't want to be, so let me think everybody's out of those rooms, I believe. Yeah, got this giant master here. Two closets back there beyond that that are both big. And got this room right here. So if you really want to see some, you know, some night to day cleanings, check. I've got right at around 1,300 videos on this channel of me doing this, cleaning and repair both, and some tile cleaning as well, and upholstery cleaning. All done this way with this machine, except for the upholstery. That's not logical. So anyway, the toughest thing for anybody to understand that cleans with steam is the difference in mindset about how this machine works and how it cleans your carpet. It's 180 degrees difference than what guys know that clean with steam and are basically boycotting this particular style of cleaning. You know, rather than injecting and extracting, you're spraying down a neutral cleaner based, run it about 7 on the pH scale, that holds the soil in suspension, and then you orbit the towel through the fibers and it transfers to the towel, and you just change the towels out. Now obviously the dirtier it is, the more frequently you'll change the towels out. I generally, when I'm cleaning with cotton, I'll generally do maybe about two rooms, maybe three. I might do one more room with that one. It's cleaning just fine and we're not that soiled. So you know, I've been really fortunate that a handful of guys have understood, you know, the message I'm sending, and they've actually switched over to this method, which makes me happy. And then there's always the guys that just hate you because you're doing it and it's not what they do. But that goes with anything. The mindset when you clean with steam is basically horsepower, horsepower, horsepower. And with this, you don't look at the cleaning that way. You look at it completely different. You look at the chemicals different. You look at the cleaning different. All of it is a completely different mindset. You know, and I made the switch, and I'm glad I did, because I don't know, you know, if I would still enjoy dragging hoses around at 46. You know, would I be able to continue to drag hoses around into my 60s, you know, and make all those footsteps and continue to be a mechanic constantly on the machines that want to break down? You can't run that much electronics with that much humidity inside of an enclosed van and expect not to have breakdowns. You'll always have breakdowns, and then you got to pay somebody to fix the machine. When you run a machine like this, you can run it, the other one ran 10 years and it's still running just fine on the van, and I had no problems. The machine is ready to work whenever you are. You know, the entire package runs you right around $2,000 with shipping. So it's a real happy place to be. It actually makes cleaning carpet fun again. All right, so I'm gonna pre-spray this carpet here. I'm gonna turn the fan off and pre-spray it, and then we'll clean this room. Actually, for fear of making the video too terribly long, I think I'm going to pre-spray it off camera and then do the cleaning. I don't know who needs to watch me pre-spray it in order to understand pre-spraying. So I'll be right back.
Now we're going to groom the carpet. The fan is blowing the wrong direction. Down, two rooms and stairs to go. And sorry, this one's not dirtier, or it would make a much better example, but this is all I got right now. I am going to change the towel out, so whenever I get to that, I'll show the towel. I'm gonna pre-spray another room and basically show. What am I going to show? I'm going to basically do a before and after on this room here. Not show the complete cleaning on these last two rooms because that's make for way too long of a video. Alright, back recording again. I pulled the towel off the machine here, so it's actually so lightly soiled that what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip it over and use it again. You can do that if they're not too light, if they're not too heavy. So I've used this side here. This is the glider that was on it. So we're going to toss this guy. And we're going to use a different glider. We're going to change sides with it since it's so, the carpet is so lightly soiled. I'm going to clean with this side. I'm going to use this glider. And still. So put that down. And that's actually made out of a CD or a DVD rather. So we're gonna use the other side, which is something that's rare as I don't know. Whatever I choose could offend somebody. And we'll just say that's pretty darn rare. Alright. Let me plug this guy in here, and we'll do a little clean. I'm not going to show the whole room. But the moral of the story here, if you're not cleaning with a Challenger, you ain't no real cowboy. So, remember that. Alright, you want to get it as close to the center as you can. That way your towel is not lopsided. So I'm going to clean some in here, show as much as I can. Thank you. Yeah, the one thing that's, so notice, I take down most of the nasty comments, but the one thing that, holds true is that most of the guys that clean with steam, they don't have a lot of positive things to say about somebody that's not cleaning with steam. Side note to that, I remember back in 2001 when I went out and bought my HydroMaster, I was talking to other guys that were in the cleaning business and they were cleaning with steam as well. I remember one guy, I told him that I was cleaning with a HydroMaster, and he goes, "Oh man, if you see me pull on the street, you better run and hide. I clean with a Vortex." So if you call that support from your fellow carpet cleaners, that's not. So, you know, it's a very cutthroat business. But the one thing that I can share about the gentleman that told me that, I'm still here and he's all gone. I don't believe he's been in business for years now, and I've just been moving along, minding my own business this whole time. You've got to put the client first. The client truly doesn't care. They want the carpet to look good. I don't know how many times I've cleaned for people, you know, multiple times. Like the sixth time, you know, they call, they go, "Hey, we need you to come out and steam again." And then you tell them, "Well, I didn't steam the last five times I was out there." "Oh, well, just whatever you do works, man. It looks great. We just want you to do that again." "I got you covered. Are you sure to do that again?" There's a new institute coming out. It's going to be the CICRC, Corey's Institute of Cleaning and Restoration Certification. Why not? You know, here's the other one. Why can't we have a new one? Do it Corey's way with the Challenger. And these guys are made right here in Texas. They're not just American made, they're Texas made. It's even better. Got to answer your own text all day. When you're a one-man show like I am, you're your own mechanic, you're your own cleaner, your own secretary, everything, all of that. Going almost too smooth today. Scary. Really scary. Told you I wasn't going to show all this, and I did anyway. Well, got more than I under promised and over delivered, I guess. That's not bad, not a bad quality. All right, I'm gonna go groom that out, and this is actually the last room. There's two closets in there to do. I promise you I'm not going to show those. We'll take a look right now, but I'm not going to show the before and after because it's just closets. I guess that conveys with the house whenever it's sold or leased, you know. And this one over here. So let's take a quick look at this big room here. Really, the only thing notably that I took out was there was a little bit of paint that I powered through. And when you're cleaning with a cotton instead of microfiber towel, the latex paint, you buzz that right out of the carpet quick. I mean, it is just gone before you know it. With microfiber, it's a little more difficult to get out because it's not as abrasive as cotton is. So, anyway, next time you see this, it'll be clean. I'm not gonna show it. So, I shall return. All right, now it's time to do the stairs. The Challenger on stairs, I guess if you had to, you could, but it's not your happy place. It's rather heavy, so I'm gonna show you how to do stairs. Get this tripod up the stairs here. Excuse me, I got the camera attached to a tripod, so trying to navigate the stairs with the tripod is a little difficult. What I do my stairs with is an Oric Orbiter. The Oric is basically your home remedy if you want to do carpet cleaning on a small scale at your home. It works exactly like the Challenger, just on a very small, lightweight scale. You know, and honestly, if you wanted to start a business where you did just a little bit of carpet cleaning, you know, once or twice a week or so, this would actually get you by. But having said that, your aspirations should be more than to work 2 to 3 days, 2 to 3 times a week. You should actually want to get to the point to where you can't keep up with this machine and you need to get a Challenger or something bigger. You won't hear many channels promoting other people's, you know, stuff. I'm a Challenger dealer, but it's perfectly fine to use one of these guys. It'll reach places like if you have a carpeted bathroom, which every once in a while you find one of those disgusting carpeted bathrooms. This will get around behind a potty, and if you want to get, you know, around big furniture and stuff, it'll get you there, and it'll does a heck of a job on the stairs. And pretty much everybody that's come across my channel that does VLM cleaning has kind of adopted my method of doing stairs. I just kind of figured out that machine would work great for stairs. I didn't know it, but I'm really happy that I finally figured that out, because up until a year or so ago, I would do the stairs with an upholstery tool, and you'd bend over the entire time you're doing the stairs, and by the time you got to the bottom and it was time to straighten back up, your back would just absolutely kill you. And now I don't have that issue. So I'm gonna start coming down the stairs with this, and you can see how simplified I've made stair cleaning. Thank you. move the camera down a little bit. This is not the perfect staircase to show stair cleaning. Got a bend in it, a couple bends in it. So, looks like, yeah, that'll have to do right there. Yeah, coming in. Stairs, and we'll take a quick look. All right, we're all done here. We'll kind of take a look and put footprints back across everything that I've already done here. There's some upstairs from the guys that were painting, walked around. So you're gonna get footprints. It's I like to leave the house with none if possible, but that's not always the case here. Well, there was the master. Little hallway here, bedroom here, and this carpet was very lightly soiled at best. So as far as me demonstrating heavy soil removal, this was not the job for that, but made a decent video anyway. All right, these are the first two that I cleaned. And they're dry, but not as they should have been dry a couple hours ago. It's extremely humid up here, which is not conducive to drying one bit. Let's see if I can find the AC to turn it on before I leave. They've had the doors open downstairs. Looks like all day. AC is off. Let me figure out how to do this. Cool. Now this, technically it's fall, so we'll just set it at about 70 here and turn the fan not on auto but on. That way when it reaches 70 degrees, it continues to cycle air across the carpet. That's what you're looking for here. So I'm gonna leave the fans on, the rooms that have fans, turn the light off. Same in here. All right, leave that on back there. Alright guys, boy that's bright. It's about all I can do there. I wanted to set this guy so when I can talk, get out of here so you don't see my bald head quite so much. Anyway, so I'm looking down because I've got my camera here seeing if I'm in frame, basically. But I want everybody to know that, you know, if you want to switch from Steam to this, you know, my phone line is open. I'll take the time with you, you know, that you need to feel comfortable doing this. If you're new wanting to get into the business, I'll spend some time with you. I get generally about 3 or 4 texts every day, guys asking questions, and sometimes they'll call. I've got to make time to talk to them. But, you know, in the event that you want to buy a Challenger, you know, what I do is if you basically buy it through me, since I'm a dealer, what I do is I'll mail you a $100 rebate out of my pocket, out of my commission. I'll mail you a $100 rebate. And then with that, you get basically a lifetime of free text support, you know, and I can also, you know, make time to take phone calls from several guys that need my help too. It's not a problem. And also I'm gonna reinstate the ride-along thing. I'll give you a 1 day ride-along to learn how to use your new equipment and soak up as much information as you can so you're comfortable using it. So, you know, my goal here is to help everybody get into VLM cleaning, maybe switch to VLM cleaning, or if you've always wanted to be a carpet guy but never wanted to go out and buy all the Steam equipment, this is a good way to do it. So, hopefully I can bring some unity to the carpet cleaning industry that's never been there before. Most of the time when you approach somebody, you know, about wanting to start a carpet business, I wasn't really accepted very warmly by guys. They would rather you not do it, that way they don't have to compete against you. It's one less person out biting for those jobs that they want. So a lot of times guys will either give you bad advice, no advice, or tell you to leave them the hell alone. That's what you won't get here. You know, I'll take the time to talk to you. Even if you went out and bought a Trinity or a whatever you call it, an Orbot. There's several different ones. You know, they make decent equipment. The Challenger comes in a little cheaper, and I know it lasts forever, so I feel comfortable with the Challenger. That's why I'm a Challenger dealer. But I won't. You know, not help you if you have a different brand of machine. That would be terrible. I would never deny anybody, you know, answers to questions. I'm basically at this point, like I said in other videos, I'm giving back to, you know, the carpet cleaning industry. I've been in it just right at about 20 years now, and I get a good feeling out of helping other guys. The whole hand up rather than hand out thing. If I can show you how to increase your income and, you know, and give you freedom in your life by buying a machine for about $2,000, you know, that honestly, if business is right, you should be able to earn your money back in a week's time. So giving away 1 week's salary for a machine that you never have to make payments on, that's splendid. That's really a big deal. If you go out and buy yourself, you know, an Oracle Orbiter, you should probably buy one used because they're everywhere used for about $150 as opposed to $500 new. I'll help you with that. Not a problem at all. There's other channels that you can watch. I'll tell you about it. Joe Wheeler has a channel. He's here in Texas as well, and he cleans everything with an Oracle Orbiter, and he does a really good job. So it's not about the brand of machine. If it's your intention to do a good job by your client, you can do it with whatever you have. You know, you just have to stand behind what you do. People know whether or not you're in it for the money or you're in it for their best interest. You know, a lot of the times the guys that they have come through the house, they hurry like crazy because they're there for a check. They're not there to get to know the homeowner. They're not there to be a friend to anybody. They're there purely to get paid and leave and then go to the next house and do the same thing. They don't plan on retaining a client for a lifetime like I do. The way I run my business, you don't have to advertise. your clientele will do it for you. Almost every job you've seen me do are for repeat clients. So the client retention rate is there. All right, I need to shut up and get back to the house and upload this video because it's been a fairly long day. If I didn't record video, I could get home a whole lot sooner. But at this point in my life, I enjoy helping others. I guess it's the age I've come to or something or something, but I enjoy helping other people. That's what I do now. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless, and I will see you tomorrow on another video.